This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about finding the equation of a line that is perpendicular to a given line and that passes through a given point. And this is actually a fairly easy process. So here's our example. I'm told to find the equation of a line that is perpendicular to y equals 4x minus 11 and that passes through the point 12, 5. Now let's talk about perpendicular lines for a second. If two lines are perpendicular, it means they intersect, and in the place where they intersect, we're going to have a right angle. Now the other thing you need to know about perpendicular lines is that if you know the slope of one of the lines, the slope of the other line is going to be the negative reciprocal of that slope. So in other words, if I had a line with a slope of 8, well, the reciprocal of 8 would be 1 over 8. The negative reciprocal would be negative 1 over 8. So the slope of the line perpendicular to the first one is going to be its negative reciprocal. Okay, so that's what you need to know about perpendicular lines. The other thing is, let's just review equations that are in the form of y equals mx plus b. So we have an equation that's in that form. We have y equals 4x minus 11. The m is going to tell us what the slope is. So if I have y equals 4x minus 11, that 4 is where the m goes. It's in the m position. And that means the slope of the line I'm given is 4. Now I want to find a line perpendicular to that. So that means its slope is going to be the negative reciprocal of 4. Well, the reciprocal of 4 would be 1 over 4. The negative reciprocal would be negative 1 over 4. So now I can start writing my equation. I'm going to have y equals the slope, negative 1 over 4 times x plus b. So I've got to find b. Now to find b, I'm going to need a point that's on the line, and I've got a point, that's 12, 5. Now when I've got a point, that point is an ordered pair, and the first value in the ordered pair, in this case the 12, is an x value. The second value in the pair, the 5, is a y value. So now I've got an x and a y that I can plug into this equation I'm working with. I'm going to take the y, which is 5, and start my equation as 5. Instead of y equals, I'll have 5 equals. Then I've got my slope, negative 1 quarter. I've got my x value. The value for x here is 12. And I'm looking for b. So it's going to be 5 equals negative 1 quarter times 12 plus b. So I can do the math and find out what b is. So let's see, that's going to be 5 equals, well, 1 quarter times 12 is 3, so negative 1 quarter times 12 would be negative 3, and then plus b. So if I add 3 to both sides, I'll find out what b is, and b equals 8. So now I can complete my equation. I'm going to be able to write y equals negative 1 quarter x plus, and I found b, b is 8. Okay, so just to repeat this process, we take the original equation we have, we take its slope, and we replace that slope with the negative reciprocal of the slope. So instead of 4, I have negative 1 quarter. So I end up with y equals negative 1 quarter x plus b. To find the b, we take the ordered pair, we take the x and y values from the ordered pair, plug them into our equation, work out the math, and that'll tell us what b is. So now we've got both the m and the b, we've got the slope and the y-intercept, so we can complete our equation y equals negative 1 quarter x plus 8. And that's all there is to it. Take care. I'll see you next time.